ever since the Christmas Eve, a few graduates from different parts of the world sent me a message saying that they buy some stock, the share price drop, you know, what are you going to do or whatever. Then I realized that it's natural that human beings, if you buy a stock and a share price drop, they will worry. So one purpose of this presentation is to assure you that when a share price drop, it could mean a few things. Yeah, okay. So my presentation topic is quite simple. In the next 20 to 25 minutes, is I'm just going to share how to maximize profit. I think there's an error. How to maximize profit out of a bear market. So in order for us to maximize our bear market, we must know what's a bear market first. So quickly, usually in the investment arena, we use term like a bull market or a bullish market or bear market or bearish market. So if you look at a bull, and then there's an arrow that goes up. Now, what does it mean? When there's a bullish market, a bull market, that means share price predominantly is going up or going down? It's going up. Going up is because the bull has two horns. The horn is always pointing upwards. So when they want to kill a predator, they roar, roar, and then they hook upwards. Go up. That's why it's called a bullish market or a bull market. Whereas for a bearish market, you can see they use the horn to go and smack someone from top to bottom. So which means that this motion represents the share price moving up or moving down. So in a nutshell, bull market is up, bear market is down. But in order for us to know that bull market is up, there must be something that goes up. It cannot be like randomly any stock. So usually there'll be one indicator that represents the entire market. When this indicator goes up, that means it's bullish. When this indicator that goes down is called bearish. So that indicator has a name and it's known as an index. So Singapore has an index. What's the Singapore's index? Straits Times Index. Then the Hong Kong has an index. What's the name of the index? Hang Seng Index. Then Japan has an index. What's the Nikkei 225? And then S&P 500. It could be Dow Jones Industrial Average. So every country, they have their own index to just represent, is it bullish or bearish. But sometimes the market don't move. Sometimes the market bullish and then after that pause for a short while. So when it pause for a short while, then analysts give another term. They call it the market is moving sideways. So in other words, there are only three terms that describe market movement. One is bullish, one is bearish, and one is what? Sideways. Sideways, that means the market is neither bullish, neither bearish. Sideways. So what is a bear market? When we say down, index go down, what does it mean? Now a bear market, technically, if you want, you can take photo, is when stocks see a 20% decline or more. That means bigger or equals to 20% from a recent high. So from a recent high, drops 20% or more. So this is called a bear market. So this is the numeric part, the quantitative part. But of course, there's a qualitative part where everybody talks about bad things. You know? Yep. So let me give you an example. Why during the Christmas Eve is considered the beginning of a bear market? Now, the recent high, 21st September 2018, this is S&P 500. So the highest point is 2929.67. Remember recent high? Recent high, and it must drop by how many percent? 20%. So the lowest is Christmas Eve. Christmas Eve is 2351.10 point. So if you see the difference is about 19.7%. So you round up to a whole number, then it's 20%. That's why analysts go, oh, it's a bear market. So this is what it means. Recent high, the lowest, 20% bear market. Yep. So right now, we understand what's a bear market, but are there any more attributes of a bear market? Now, there are a lot of research that's being done, but one article that I came across, it says that since World War II, bear markets have lasted 13 months on average. Wow, 13 months, that means, from Christmas Eve, it may last at the end of the year. But remember, here it's on average. It doesn't mean that this time around is 13 months. You say on average. And stock markets tend to lose how many? 30% of their value. But lucky ours only lose about 20%. Now, then the next one, during those conditions, when the bear market takes place, it usually takes stocks an average of 22 months to recover, which is almost close to 2 years. Yep, according to analysis from Goldman Sachs and then CNBC. So let me show you some numbers which starts from World War II. Wow, it's like going back history. Now, these are the bear market. Now, you don't really have to, if you want to take photo, I won't stop you, but you don't really have to. Now, these are some of the data. Here, there is a column that says start. That means this is the beginning of a bear market. And this is the ending of a bear market. And during this period, some event took place, the share price dropped minus 10%. Okay, and how long does it last? Yeah, 1 month. Then the recovery take what? 1 month. So the second one, this one lasted what? The share price dropped 28%. It lasted how long? 28 months. And then the recovery, 21 months, the recovery is 28 months. So there's a whole list of data. I can go on and on. So here I have data from 1946, which is World War what? Two, until today. Today is 18. So if I could summarize whatever this in Excel file, and then I could summarize it, what does it mean? It simply means that whenever on average, based on this data, whenever there's a bear market, remember the share price dropped by about what? 30%. The average duration is about 13 months, which is about 1 year, and the recovery take more than 13 months on average, based on the past. Now, so sometimes you hear terms called correction. Now, correction happens more than bear market. Like bear market more serious. Why? Because bear market is 30% and here drop what? 13%. So because it's less serious, do you realize that duration is shorter? Yeah, shorter, and then recovery is also shorter. So whenever there's a bull market, usually there'll be some correction. Oh, it drops down, then goes up a bit, and drops down, goes up a bit. Now, so bear market, keep in mind, 20% correction, maybe about 10%, but day-to-day fluctuation is about 3%. So sometimes plus 3%, sometimes negative 3%. So don't go and look at day-to-day, it is useless one. Yeah. So just take note, day-to-day is about 3%. Anything close to 10% is a correction. Anything 20% is a bear market. Easy, right? Day-to-day, and then correction, and then bear market. Yep. So now we have a feel of what is a correction. What is a day-to-day 3%? What's a correction 10%? And what is a bear market 30%? But the question is, so what? Now, in the bear market, or during a correction, there are two things that could happen. One, we can see as a problem. So Chinese is way. And the other one, we can see as opportunity, which is T. Now, if it's a Confucius teacher or somebody talk about principles, this one sounds quite nice. But the question is, what does it mean? Technically, what does it mean? What can I do? Can they give me some specific? Now, how can I see this danger as an opportunity? Now, I just want to let you know that most people, maybe more than 90% who are watching this video, they'll see it as a problem. Now, they see it as a problem because they have absolutely no idea what is going on. Yeah, and if every day you give them a crisis, they wouldn't know how to take advantage of it. Partly because they do not have the knowledge. Now, unlike all of you. Now, today you set aside time, come here and then listen to this. So now the question is, while most people perceive bear market correction as a danger, so what do we mean by opportunity? How can we see this as opportunity?